In this episode, Golden and I discuss the Doctor Who 2021 holiday special, Revolution of the Daleks. Full speed ahead.
The Omega Beam. Full power.
Welcome to the Omega Beam number 111. I'm your host, Oren Merton. So the Doctor Who holiday special is a long-standing tradition, and no global pandemic is going to stand in the way of that. So on New Year's Day 2021, the BBC, in the USA, BBC America, aired Revenge of the Daleks, which is this year's holiday special. You can still stream it on the BBC or BBC America apps. You can get it on iTunes and other online retailers. I'm sure it'll make its way to streaming and to disc soon. So if you haven't seen it, we're going to keep the spoilers nice and low. If you have, well, you're set either way. So let's get to it. I am here with Golden to talk about the 2021 Doctor Who holiday special, The Revolution of the Daleks. So what did you think?
Well, Revolution of the Daleks picks up where the last episode left us.
Right.
I think that it had been so long since the last episode. I really feel like I should have gone back and watched the previous two or three episodes before watching it.
Sure.
Because I was a little lost because I didn't remember exactly.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just a lot of fun. I mean, you know from previews, I don't really feel like this is a spoiler because you know from previews that Jack is back.
Jack is back.
And
Captain Jack Harkness.
These are, ever since she took over as the Doctor, I just feel like this entire cast just makes such a nice unit.
Mm-hmm.
It's not the Doctor and the companions. It's all of them.
Right. And I think it was a great change with Jodie Whittaker and the 13th Doctor that instead of sort of the Doctor and the one opposite sex companion that is either a love interest or a friend or a pet or whatever, that it is a group of people. I think it made for a more interesting set of adventures with these people. And it also harkened back to the original days because the original Doctor Who was with a group of people and not with a single companion as well. I thought that bringing Jack back was great. I love the character of Captain Jack Harkness. I love John Barrowman as an actor and what he brings to the table. I thought he had a great rapport with the Doctor and with all the companions.
Yes. Well, I like one of the last episodes where he's not even sure what the Doctor looks like now, so he's taking one of the companions as
right. The
Doctor at first.
Right, right. Lots of fun there.
And just has fun with it.
Oh, yeah, yeah, absolutely. And I think that this episode was also a little bit more action-packed than some of the more sort of talky-talky. You know, one of my issues with Doctor Who, I really enjoy Doctor Who, but this is especially true of the older series, but even now in you know, since the 2005 reboot, some episodes kind of almost read more like a stage play. Like everyone stands around and discusses what's happening. And this was a really action-packed episode. You had things going on in different locations and the companions running this way and that and always in various amounts of threat. And you had betrayal and deception, and of course you have Daleks because, you know, you have Daleks. You can't have a show called Revolution of the Daleks without Daleks. I think every year the effects always get better and better. So I thought that was fun.
And I know that you're not I don't think you're a fan of the newer opening.
I'm not a fan of the newer opening.
I kind of like how this opening feels like a heartbeat, though.
It does kind of feel like a heartbeat. It's not the worst opening. I felt that maybe the 12th Doctor had the worst. I just feel that this one, you know, is not quite as good as the Eccleston, Tennant, or Smith years. but it's, you know, it's fine. I love the theme song to Doctor Who. I just think sometimes they try and manipulate it so it's always a little fresh, and sometimes it's better than others. The particular manipulation they do to make it sound different than it did in the 60s. But overall, I'd say this is a ton of fun. If you've been enjoying the 13th Doctor, this episode will not disappoint. Actually, if it does disappoint, the disappointment is going to be that after the holiday special, we're going to have to wait until we get the next season. That is the disappointment. But there won't be any disappointment about the episode that we watch.
And it's interesting to kind of learn more or see more about the Daleks each time.
Yeah, every time they always kind of increase the lore. They always add to the lore, and without necessarily retconning it. You know, they bring in pieces of the lore, they add to the lore, and they don't try and deny or erase what came before, which, you know, that's always nice. So yeah, it was a well-written, well-executed story.
There is one point of contention that a lot of Doctor Who fans are having.
There is, huh?
Yes, and it has to do with the TARDIS and how the Doctor treats the TARDIS.
Oh, I see.
And I get that. I don't know what the solution is, but I think we could probably figure out one where it's valid and it doesn't go against the Doctor's ethics.
Yeah, well, you know, the Doctor's...
But I'm not going to say what my guess is, because I don't want to put a spoiler out there.
I think some people who are fans, they just love to nitpick.
And they also take it very seriously.
Yeah, this is one of those...
It's like it's their child.
Yeah, I mean, if you want to nitpick, then you can. I always go back to the 10th Doctor, to the David Tennant Doctor, where... In the great episode, Blink, he uses the phrase timey-wimey. And I think the phrase timey-wimey really sums up Doctor Who, that this is not a show that if you're looking for something that has hard science, you can really nitpick. This isn't the one. And it's a roller coaster. You just get on it, get on the ride, and enjoy it. You can nitpick pieces of it, but I just don't think it's worth doing.
Yeah, I thought it was interesting. Someone that I know on Facebook was saying that he tried to watch it for the first time, mm-hmm. and he couldn't get over the fact that the special effects were just not the higher quality that he expected.
Yeah, well,
but you know. Part of that is they're still drawing from old Doctor Who. And I think part of that is what gives us its charm.
If you enjoy Doctor Who, then you know what you're getting. I don't see a point in tearing it apart and nitpicking it. You either enjoy it for what it is, or don't bother. That's the way I see it. If you're a Doctor Who fan, you are going to like this episode, because it is a well-done Doctor Who episode. If you are looking for unique, hard science fiction with billion-dollar effects, you probably aren't going to enjoy Doctor Who at all, and this episode will probably just be another one of the ones you wouldn't enjoy.
Okay.
But I would say if you're a fan...
Especially if you like Daleks.
Oh, yeah. If you love Daleks, you'll love this episode, because they certainly get their time to shine, or maybe to sneer, to...
To
exterminate. There we go. The equivalent.
Exterminate.
Exactly. Daleks are always going to be evil in some way. Although there was that one episode where they had, you know, a reprogrammed Dalek that wasn't so evil. I don't remember exactly the details anymore because it was seasons ago.
But that
wasn't
a true Dalek.
It wasn't a true Dalek.
No.
And there's apparently a real hierarchy of Daleks. You know, there's like the master race Daleks that kill off other Daleks, and then there's the other Daleks, and there's a lot of Daleks out there, and they all have their own supremacy complexes. Well, thank you, Golden.
You're welcome.
And that's it for this episode. You can find the show notes at theomegabeam.com/111. If you like this episode, please leave a review wherever you listen to podcasts. Reviews help people who like this stuff find our podcast. If you have any comments or suggestions, please drop us a line at info@theomegabeam.com. Be good to yourselves and each other, and we'll catch you next time.
The Omega Beam. Full stop.